Hello everyone, my name is Mickey, call sign Yankee Tango 9 Tango Tango, and today we are going to talk about OpenCPN and how to connect OpenCPN with the RTL-SDR dongle, that specialized receiver that we can use to decode and show information about other vessels in OpenCPN. First of all, I would like to mention that there's a great guide on TechMind channel where they show AIS catcher software on Windows-based PC. But there's a lack of information how you can integrate OpenCPN with AIS catcher. As I mentioned, you're gonna need SDR receiver. You can choose between RTL-SDR version 3, that's a great receiver, open for all frequencies, and also you can use Shipxplorer AIS dongle, that's only for reception of AIS signals because it has a built-in filter and preamplifier, so you can only use that for AIS signals. Today, I will not going to be talking about installation of drivers for the receivers. You can find the installation procedures on Quick Start Guide on RTL-SDR site. Also, you can find a procedure for installing drivers. We are going to focus about OpenCPN and installing drivers and plugins to communicate with decoder. For today's occasion, I already downloaded and installed OpenCPN, so we are going to configure it to work with RTL-SDR dongle. First, we're going to need one plugin for RTL-SDR, and I will leave the links in description of this video. We're going to need RTL-SDR Pi 131 version. I already downloaded necessary files on my desktop, so we're going to install. This is simple, small software, and installation should run smoothly and very short. As you can see, I used all default installation options. Second, we need to open folder where the OpenCPN is actually installed. You can see I'm using this Windows-based PC, and we're gonna open, let's close all those windows, and I'm going to right click on this icon and go to open file location. Yeah, you can see it went to the disk C, program files, OpenCPN. We're going to create some folders in this plugin folder. We're going to create new folder. Windows might complain about access denied, just click continue. The folder that we need is going to be RTL-SDR_Pi. We're going to open that folder and create new folder called bin. That's the place where we will extract the decoder itself. The decoder we're going to use great software. It's called AIS Catcher. We're going to download the latest version 0.44, and I already downloaded to my desktop folder. Here it is. We can extract that folder. We're going to get all those files, and we are going to copy all of the files back to the bin folder that we created a few minutes ago. Next, for the plugin to recognize the new decoder, we have to rename it because the original plugin was meant for other type of other program to decode called RTL_AIS. So we're simply just going to rename this file And yes, I want to leave it like that. That's about it for manual stuff. Now we can run OpenCPN and tweak everything to run smoothly. First, I'm inland in the capital of Serbia called Belgrade. We have two rivers, Danube and Sava. There's not much of river traffic, but we will see if the actual vessels will be decoded. First, we need to go to this gearbox and enable that plugin that we installed. You can see it's all grayed because we didn't enable that button. And soon we click this checkbox and hit apply. From the left side, we will see a small antenna will show up. And we need to enter additional parameters for decoder to communicate with RTL-SDR properly. For this occasion, AIS-catcher need input what type of device you are using. We are using RTL-SDR. It has 0 ppm error correction. We're going to use default values for decoder, and we need to output that information to the localhost port 10110. If it's all okay, we will hit OK, and here it is, the tower like icon showed up. If I hit enable, you can see the decoder will run, and if there are some AIS signals, we will see them over here. Right now we're going to need execution failed. We'll replug the dongle, maybe something is using it, and try again. Yeah, we can see now it showed first message on the screen, but that message is not imported into OpenCPN because it is not listening that port that we configured previously. So we must go to the gearbox again, go to connections, and I already configured it, but we can remove and do that again. So we are going to add new connection. We are choosing network connection. We are using UDP protocol. The address is localhost. And data port is 10110. We don't need to enter any additional parameters. That's just a basic listening UDP port. We will hit apply. And while we are in this window, we will check show debug window so we can see is the OpenCPN actually getting input from the receiver. And you can see one vessel did show up over here. And probably those messages are belonging to this vessel. When I go over here to see what kind of vessel it is, you can see its speed, course, and report age as the vessel is moving. You can see how many seconds between last signal received is over here. As long you have plugged in dongle, next time you run OpenCPN, this icon and this checkbox will be default enabled, and OpenCPN will immediately start to decode those signals. So let's try that option one more time. I will replug the dongle. You can hear the sound of actual plugging in back. So if I run OpenCPN, we will see in a few seconds, we will see vessels showing up over here. Yeah, you can see the signals, you can see the decode messages, and that's about it. For all other information, I will leave in description some additional options where you can use some additional parameters like a web interface for AIS catcher that's integrated in decoder itself. I can enable it right here. At the end of this string, I will add minus N and port, let's say, like this. We will. You can see the Windows firewall is complaining, but it's okay. You can allow access to decoder to display local web interface to see Google Maps or other type of the maps. We can go to the localhost and port 8100, as I explained. You can see that's procedure almost exactly like the TouchMind video. So you can use this as a backup. If you don't have OpenCPN, you can use this as a backup options to see all the ships on a map. That's it for today. If you do have any comments, leave them in description. I will try, I will do my best to answer on all those questions. See you next time. 73, bye.